All right, well, guys, it's time for a new randomizer. My original plan was Ocarina of Time. However, I heard about this and decided, I think I want to do this one a bit more first. So we're going to do the Lufia 2 Terror Wave open world randomizer created by Abyssinim, I believe the name is pronounced. Of course, I'm using the Fru Lufia hack as the base, since that is compatible with it. And I basically have everything randomized, though I do have the difficulty lowered a little bit, just for the sake of a first run to get used to this. I'm not going into this entirely blind, I've seen Omegas run a few seeds, but I do have an idea of what I'm doing, and well, just see how things go. So I'm going to retry mode just for a quick experience, and not necessarily starting with Maxim. Who do we get? Oh, Tia! Running with a dragon egg, huh? Okay, we're starting in Portravia, I believe. Okay, so return here after rescuing the three maidens to go to Doom Island. So we have to find the three sisters. And take our ship. Now, it is open world, but we start with the Excelion and do not necessarily get the submarine or airship until after some upgrades. I wonder if Lucifer is in a place where you might find a water ring and a chest. Okay, so we got some different dialogue. I'm not going to talk to everybody. Oh boy, so yeah, we got sounds like randomized monsters. Randomized items, 3,000 gold. See. Definitely randomized items. It's nice to start off with a, It would be nice to start off with a place that sells, like, X-Boomers or Dragon Teeth, just to do some early grinds at the start. But yeah, I'll be checking shops. The nice thing is, with Tia in the party, I do have early access to Warp once I get it. Liar! I found an item shop. Oh, hello. Can't equip either of those. These are well out of my league. Okay, so we get the 10 potions to start with. Yay! Actually, I should check Portravia too. Because if you can get a decent start, it's possible to get some early levels. Okay, items. Yeah, power drug! Smoke. Okay, well, high boomerang, that's better than nothing. Let's see, rapier. I can afford the rope, go ahead and get that. I can probably do some early dungeons as a result of this. Just have to sail my way over. And one thing they did add is there are save points at the start of each dungeon. But definitely want to save often early on, because you're going to get wrecked. Not careful. Starting at level 5. Only 47 HP. That's, Actually, is there a magic... There should be a magic shop here, too. Not that I can really afford much. And... Not a whole lot. That's okay. I haven't played the game since I did my LP of Speculufia, so it's a... It's a little bit of... I need a refresher. Alright, there's the Sacred Shrine. Castle Buster Shrine. Oh, free item. Or... hello? Nope, I can't interact with this. Oh, that sucks. Normally, you would fight a boss, and then the monster, it would drop a crown or something. That would be your item. Though I don't know if that's a problem or not. And looks like they did remove it in random encounters from the open seas, which is good. I need to find my way to Elcid and start simple. But it's been a while since I played. Don't remember the map. Thundleton? Alright. The dragon is in its house, just telling me where monsters are. Well, you also have high boomerangs. And. Yeah, let's go ahead and buy that dagger. It's certainly a little bit better. There we go. Should be able to handle some early stuff now. But every town should every dungeon should have a boss, leading to a character or an item. Yep, nothing good here. So yeah, it looks like the later towns will have better stuff in general. Hey Milk, what are you doing here? Oh, nice! Hold RA, press L to use, okay. Oh, that's a nice, touch. Alright, worst comes to worst, I just have to do a couple fights and... That's right, just hold L for the quick select. Kind of a little funny watching Tia swing the sword and shoot the arrows here. But in essence, the original game did have dummied out sprites of all the characters being able to be playable in dungeons rather than have Maxim all the time. So these are not custom sprites. These were in the original game. Okay, this is not the kill all monsters in the room, but oh well. Yep, boss. Oh, I'm gonna die. I'm so gonna die. Oh. Glitchy graphics. I don't know if that's from the ROM hack or just the... Or as a result of the randomizer. If this doesn't work, I'll just do a base ROM. Yeah, the tricky part at the start here is definitely finding a place where you can survive. Oh, double attack. And second round, here we go. The other thing is, since you find the keys, various dungeons, as part of your, I'll take that, as part of the exploration, I don't necessarily have to do every single dungeon. But again, this is just a refresher on how things are laid out and where to go. Thought I'd randomize the monster movements, but that's not quite the case, looks like. Hey! Number two! There we go, a couple levels up and I'll be fine. Actually, another place I could go is the Capsule Monster Shrine with Fumi. That should be a free one too. Of course, ideally, the best thing to get is the submarine or the airship so you can just grind outside of Chaid. Oh, been too long. Where's that passage? Wrong button. Oh, poop. Actually, wait a sec. If I remember correctly, there's a hidden passage here. No. Probably on the other side of the bridge then. And this good old spot. I'm just pushing the wrong button. Ah, yes, a lizard. Yoshi's favorite sprite in this. Oh, teleporting bats! Yeah, monster movement is randomized. Ah! Oh, that was cheap. Fortunately, not a surprise attack. Before I go on, I want to double check what's back in this other room. Maybe get another level up in the process, too. Oh, the hookshot post, that's it. Hey, you guys, don't sneak up on me. Actually, if I can get to 10 bell, I wonder if there's a spot where an item where guy normally joins. I'll check that too. Yeah, you don't move, spider. There's the passage. I think only Lexus can equip that. Yep. That's a darn shame. Worst comes worst is if I die, I have to walk out of here. Oh, the followers. This is death. Yep, try again. The nice thing is I can afford some magic now, but gotta walk out. If I can find escape and warp, that'll be perfect. Yeah, I can't do the late cave because I need the late key to fight the boss there. No point in doing that. It's just a matter of going to where you can hopefully complete things, but at the same time, probably also going to have to take time to level up. Hopefully find some characters at the same time. That's all we can do from here. I parked my ship on the other side, didn't I? Strong and detox. Well, oh no, she can't learn strong. Oh boy, this is what happens when you randomize who can learn what spells too. Oh boy. And of course, you're not selling any escape items, so oh boy, this just got a little scarier. Hopefully, she can learn other healing spells, but where'd I park my ship? Okay, right here, good. Counter rate! And magic shop, where are you in this town? Wait, got the tea house. Let's see what they got. Oh, she can't equip the glass pierce, and yet that's what's given to her in the vanilla game, if I remember correctly. See, you did not. Okay, well, you escapes never hurt. Bye for now. Let's see. Well, Flash is always a good one. Very good. Mighty Tights forever! Thank you for the follow! Now be sure to wear them when you join my army! Oh, can't sail under bridges. Actually, I better save before I attempt another spot. I gotta go around that spot too. Dang it! I'm gonna try the Fumi spot, just be. See if there's anything I can kill there. If not, I gotta wander. Let's see, I guess I could also try the cave to Tanbell, or. Now, the Illusion's North Cave. Oh, hi. Catfish! I think I can kill you! The problem is, I don't have any healing magic, but that's okay. Oh, tweak would be nice, but, I do have 10 potions. Hey! Oh, ouch! Oh, ouch! That's not good! That's not good! And I'm alive! I'm alive! Oh, I need more than that. Yeah, do the weak attacks. And, well, let's just see how this does. Okay, that worked. No catfish jewel, but two levels. And, hey, gusto! Not progression, but hey, any little bit helps. Oh, wait. That's right, castle monsters are randomized too. That's okay. Fumi is a good all-rounder. Running into Loons for a quick heal here. Was it that far away this whole time? Dang it! Oh well. Fumi's actually off to a really good start here. Oh, Dragon Fang. I don't know if it's better than the High Boomer or not, but a few of those may keep me alive. Bright Knife. I'm just pressing all the wrong buttons today. Let's see. Yeah, I'll sacrifice one for a weapon upgrade. And anything else? It can wait. Okay, Lunze does not have a magic shop, looks like. Casino's in the inn. Speaking of the inn, that's where I want to go. Can't do anything in the castle basement until I find bombs. Though a lot of this is pretty limited until I find... I'd like that holy staff. It'd be quite nice for the... for endgame. Alright, so... popped off. We got a couple levels. I might be able to kill those followers now. I guess a little bit of extra armor would be nice, too. North Cave, so, well, see what we got here. But this is where we can get plenty of treasure. And some power drugs! Yeah! Well, it still wasn't a back attack. Boomy punch! Two best words to see in this game. And of course, since we only have one, well, technically two characters right now, we are getting the most of the experience. I remember when Tim found one of these in his current LP, he said, oh, that's a... well, agility drop. Eh. Could probably get by without it for now. If I find Guy, I'll give him the jet helm. Yeah, I think that I do have the difficulty it's set at 0.4 rather than at least 1, so I think that's why enemies are a little bit easier right now. Hey, Karant. So far, so good. I've gotten past one boss. But this is the perfect excuse to revisit one of my all-time favorite SNES games, since I have not replayed it since I did my Let's Play. Brave Swords, that'll increase guts. Goddess Idol. It's a random generic sprite, though. Okay, that's one thing found in the Forfeit Isle casino that I never bought. Oh, in terms of Tim's LP, he's at the first spot I was been waiting for him to get to. But once he finishes his next dungeon. Of course, the funny thing is, he solved one of the puzzles that took me a long, long time as a kid on the first try. And you can equip the Witch Ring. It's one of her better rings in vanilla, too. Oh, yeah, face me, why don't you? Boomy punch! That's right, I did not solve the puzzle over there, so no ladder. Oh, the YouTube comments congratulated him quite a bit. But I will say, Tim missed that chest down there. He never went through the secret passage. Oh, EX Boomer! No for strike. I've got to drain the water on both sides in order to reach the boss. I think there's a save point in front of it, too. Which would be good, because I don't want to lose all this progress. Oh. Actually, no, the save point was not there. But depending on what the sprite is, I may or may not survive. We'll see what we got. Worst comes to worst, I can probably make my way to Parcelite, try grinding on some cores. Oh, never mind. Save point. Right there. And another crown, which is nothing. So, I honestly don't know if that's just the randomizer not working properly, if it's just nothing, but since I need the bombs there, I forgot about that. I'm gonna walk out. My potion. Oh, another Dragon Fang, I'll take those. Oh, Kukri. Can you equip it, though? Though I don't think it's better than the mace. Answer is no. Alright, let's get out of here.